When the pandemic came, I found enough time to tackle medical billing, specifically using the CMS 1500, the mainstay of web-free paper billing. This mail-in billing form draws from six related sets of data: client, health insurance companies, counselor, billable activities, charges, and diagnoses. So let's see what I pulled together so far. This is a work in progress. You can download three files to see and use for free. First, we see Word files. These are sample forms, mine, such as intake, payment, agreements, informed consent, labels, stationery, and invoices. Each you will want to name and redesign as you see fit. Notice on the payment agreement there are two clauses, one that helps you identify what happens if you get taken to court, and another one that helps you get back some of the administrative costs working with companies that only pay half rate. Informed consent is always a good idea. As I left behind paper files, I grew concerned about the client record security, confidentiality, and the danger of being hacked. My fears were confirmed. In turn, I soon lost client data held by Anthem, Magellan, Blue Cross Blue Shield, and Medicaid. Some breaches were statewide, others nationwide. I decided to keep medical records myself. This meant better data backup and redundancy using three or four computers. It meant never accessing the web on computers dedicated to client data. At first, I bought software. I used Sometimes and Notes 444, but such software restricted how I input, output, and use the data, and I wanted more creative control. So, as my colleagues began to use online records and billing, I searched for something as easy to use as online service and common to most computers. Let's see how the template thing works. We have a file here of templates. It's really useful for note-taking. Here's the note-taking template. You can see that you can do a checklist, and then if you wanted to add some treatment plans, you can pull up the treatment plan template that you can modify yourself and resave as a template. But here it is. You take whatever you want to treat in the treatment plan, whatever you do, and put it in the treatment plan note and the template. And you know, you may have one more than one thing. Maybe you want to do some DBT with the person. You can go get that off the treatment plan and stick that in here too. Then you can write down a note. At first I worked with the templates in Excel, but they didn't really lend themselves well to word processing. So then I switched to using the templates in Word, and I think it works better. I do have hope that the one in Excel will be able to input the date at the time that you input the note. I'm not there yet, so it's still a work in progress. The other thing you can do with templates, of course, is, you know, like have common letters, like pet letters that you write for clients that need a animal for pets, and you just pull up the pet letter, put in particulars, and it's ready to go. So here we are saving the template as the client's data, and we will later on put it in a client file. There are good free relational database apps, but I found it cumbersome to master yet another software when I had not mastered the ones I had. I wanted something I was supposed to know already. Eventually, I settled on Microsoft Office. I knew Word, and I began to pick up Excel watching YouTube. Would have been nice to use Access, but most counselors do not have nor know how to use this Microsoft Office database app. I spent the next few years just doing taxes in Excel. You have to store the templates in the Word application support, which on a Mac computer is in the library. And if you look in the library under application support, you'll find eventually Microsoft, and then eventually you'll find My Templates. And down you go. Let's see, Microsoft, there we go. And we're looking for My Templates. rigs going there. That way, whenever you're inside the program and you want to just hit new from template, you can do that, and it will give you the choice to use this as one of your personal templates. The third file that you can download for free after the Word and the template file is the Excel file itself. Now this is the worksheet. It's called Excel Counselor in this particular application. You can give it your own name. We've got five fictitious clients, and you can type over their name and put in your names. Use the same format. There's 25 pieces of data that you have to collect for a CMS 1500. You can get that off the intake form, obviously, that if you still want to use that in writing, they can. And you input it here. You're going to be using the CMS 1500, which is a big scary form that uses six databases. Here it is in its entirety. So here it is on the program. If you look down along a worksheet, you'll see that there's little tabs at the bottom. So if you look and hit the CMS 1500, you're going to see that it automatically has a form that fills that form out. Okay, this took a lot of programming to get this to work. But right now all you have to do is pull down the client's name and all the data changes. The only stuff I haven't changed yet is this, the dates. And you'll have to do that by hand until I get that perfected. It is a work in progress. You don't really fill out Excel data where you think it is on the form. I mean, you can go down to the cell and fill it out down there, but you really want to look up at the bar. And at the top of the page, you will see that's a better, there's a little place, little window that you can fill your data in, and that tells you what to put in. So the client log, here's, you keep track of all the activities that you do with your clients, unless you want to copy all your CMS 1500s to their client file. And here's how you do it. You take the client, now notice that it has a pull down menu on the first column, and you pull down that client's name. Then you want to diagnose them, you go to the diagnosis page, you copy the diagnosis cell, take that with you back to the previous page. Whenever we're ready, there we go. And put it in here. And then you put the rest of that data that's going to be the same as it is up above for that client. So you can just put the rest in by copying it. In fact, you can do three or four dates at the same time that way and then just change the dates. So anyway, but you just the copy is, you know, Command C, and to paste is Command V, just like it is in WordPerfect. I mean in Word. So you can see that's pretty expedient. That the log doesn't load on the CMS 1500 yet, so you still have to keep track of the dates and put the CMS 1500 dates in yourself. But I'm working on that. Unless someone else shows me. Next year, I will figure out how to get dates to fill the CMS 1500 and invoices from the client log. For now, I am content to type it in. I have used the design to bill for the last 6 months. My practice shrank, and that meant beta testing with a smaller, more manageable set of active clients. Anyway, so a few things about Excel that you should know. You can select a cell by pointing your arrow in it. When you select it, you'll get a black cross. The black cross can be used to copy that cell to the cell below it. See how you can do that? And if it's a formula, such as this cell, then it'll copy the formula. If you look up in the formula viewing window up at the top there, you'll see that that's true. Okay, a lot of times you'll want to do all your input up there at the top in the viewing window because you can see what is actually in that. And then sometimes you have these weird formats for dates, and it's just easier to look up in the window up above and change the date rather than use the strange CMS 1500 format that they use for dates. Cells work the same. You can go into a cell, you can change the numbers up at the top window or down below. I always find it easier up at the top window. If you want to delete something, you just hit enter and everything will go away. On this particular form, it adds itself, so even if you take all these people out, they're still going to have the same right total at the bottom. And so that's kind of convenient. You have to know what a pull-down menu is, and so if you go in the first cell of something, it has little black arrows over on the side there. You'll want to see what are the selections there. Here you can select a therapist, for example, in case you got the wrong therapist on that CMS 1500. And that should change all the NPIs and all the tax information related to that therapist that are on the form at the same time. So those are pretty convenient pull down things. That's also how you selected the client for the CMS 1500, obviously. You can select the whole form, and that's kind of a cool process, because then you can take a form here and put it in Word and then maybe save it to a client file. So here you just go up to the first cell and then down to the bottom cell, shift, and then hit the bottom cell, tap it, and there you see, you got to highlight that, and you can copy that and just take that whole thing, and you can go put it in the stationery, for example, you know your Word file. Here we go. So this is stationery, and margins probably won't work. Better try a different one. I'll still have to change the margins. So let me change the margins to like half an inch. CMS 1500 uses every inch of the paper. You can buy them pre-printed at a office supply store. And while you're there, get some number 10 right windowed envelopes, because you can fold them and mail them without labels. The invoices too. Okay, now this should fit. And the convenient thing about this is obviously you can save this into the client file, and then later on, if it turns out you made a mistake on the CMS 1500, you come back, correct it, and reprint it. So that's useful. You do a Command V and eventually it shows up on this form. Still doesn't fit. There you go. Well, anyway, you get the idea. This makes more sense maybe if I use an example of the invoice. So let's save this as our valued most valued client. We'll save this and move on, try to do an invoice instead. Wait a sec. That won't take that. See, yeah, right. So let's put a number 2 on it. So they're both hanging out in the document file, waiting for me to put them in the client file. So let's go over to Excel again, and let's go to the invoice. And the invoice is a tab down at the bottom, and you have a name choice up at the top of who your client might be. Boom, pick that person, make sure that their dates are correct, or correct them as you need. They will add up on their own. And once you think you've got it where you want it, then go up to the uppermost corner, tap it, click, and then go hit the shift key and tap the bottommost corner, and that'll give you the whole form. Copy it, and then we'll go over to Word again, and you can actually put this in your stationery, so, and hence in your client file, and that's kind of nice. Then you have a record every month or every time you do billing of what you sent the client. right in on top of that. Well, margins don't work, remember, right? So let's change the margins. Okay, I'll do that. Be close enough anyway. You get the idea. Boom. Yeah, well, that's two pages. That's more than I want, but probably delete some lines. So yeah, you can save it. Or not, but you can put it into the documents. And then at the end of all that, you can, of course, close all this out, and you can put the, oh wait, here's your therapist line. You want to make sure that you look at these different things here. This is the therapist data that you have for the CMS 1500. Let's see. There's diagnoses that you get from the APA DSM-5. Insurance companies, you need to know them. There we go. We already did the counselor thing. Let's see. You also have just a list, you know, things that, you know, drive those question when you ask you, you know, what do you want? These are the different lists. And this, you can change these, you can add to them. You know, pretty much want to insert a column, make them a little bit, it's the same thing. And then when you save your program, you close it down and enjoy it. If you can fix it better than this, then definitely contact me. If not, good luck with it, and maybe your administrative person will like it better. I tried teaching my partner how to do this, and she was very glad that I had undertaken the project, but she was glad that I continued to do the bookwork. And like most counselors, they dread paperwork, and this seems like a big bother. So she wanted me to do it and continued to do it. So I used this design for her billing too, and we got one cycle of billing to work for her. So I guess this is a YouTube for those who do their billing. It has helped me, and I hope it helps you. If you have any improvements that you can make to it, definitely contact me. Otherwise, I am done with this one, and I'm done with this pandemic year. I'm ready for something different. Thank you. One last detail, of course, we forgot to put our client files in the client files. So, in here we are. We're looking in documents. And in documents, you'll find those two, and they need to go in the client file. There we go. Okay, now we're done. Enjoy.